Ground tuck in radio, whether it's a radio guy that does something stupid on the other coast, the whole industry buckles down.
Yep.
That's what they do. The whole industry reacts and buckles down and freaks out. And that's exactly what the FCC did, and they knew it.
And they and you know what? You want to hear this, Tucker? They filed on us on the very last day that they could have filed.
Yeah, the complaint expired the next day, so we got our fine one day before the complaint expired.
That's just disgusting.
All in
absolutely disgusting.
All just to solidify the Nipplegate deal.
Yeah, and the complaint got as far as it did because we outed a terrorist that was making money working at one of our public universities.
That's why the guy in Jacksonville was given the help, because Salon.com had aligned themselves with him. And the reason why Salon.com was mad is because we outed a terrorist and would not sit there and pander to him like all the other media would. We're like, this guy's a scumbag, and here's what he's done, and his death to Israel, and the things that the guy had said. And man, we were, you know, we were public enemy number one. All while, all we were really guilty of doing is just trying to tell the public what this guy, what this terror.
After all this,
can I just ask you one question though? Why is it that the left instinctively defends Islamic nutcases?
That's a great question.
Because if they actually came to power, the first people to be executed would be gays, feminists, other, you know, would be the left.
Pot smokers, right. Liberals.
Right. Exactly. No, that's right.
They would all
and
be
yet
gone.
They defend them instinctively. And I think it's because they hate America more than they hate Islamic extremists. I don't really know what's the other answer.
I really don't get that. Yeah. I really don't get that at all.
Anyway, Todd.
You got me going.
Yeah, you got me. Now I was hot. Now I'm mad. Now I was.
My blood pressure is high.
I almost feel like
I gotta get an EKG right now.
Like I'm almost going through rehab, Brent. Where your therapist would say there's three forms of healing: sad, mad, glad. And I'm now mad at Tucker. I was sad.
Really?
Mad,
I feel like I'm going through menopause. I'm having a hot flash right now.
Well, you know why? Because your libertarian instincts are kicking in.
Yeah.
That's why.
Well, I mean, I don't have a problem changing my mind based on evidence, ever. I change my mind off, except with Al Sharpton. Obviously, that's true love. That defies reason.
We might as well just let that go.
I think we really should. I mean, so I just have an unreasonable, pre-rational attachment.
So we'll
to
agree
Al Sharpton,
to
probably homoerotic in nature.
Well, we will agree to let you off the Al Sharpton. I'm homo for him. You guys will never get me to change. If you will agree to look at this Senate race,
I'm going to literally do it right now. I've just written a note to myself.
And then by next Wednesday, I'd like to have you on next Wednesday. By next Wednesday, for you to give us your findings.
Done. I'll put a reporter on it.
Well, no, how about yourself?
That's too hard, man. That's like work.
That's what he pays people to do.
But at the end of the day, man, are you going to get that reporter's slanted opinions?
No. We've got hardcore news reporters from newspapers and stuff.
And I've got to give your site a compliment, a real compliment. There is original content there. It's just not a content aggregator like a lot of these sites are. There's a lot of original content
there.
They're
just not rehashing other people's stuff. They're
including from a man called Brent Hatley. Something of a sports expert.
He's an expert about something. We haven't figured it out yet.
You've got to read, this is the last thing I'll say, the Roger Stone Fashion Review this morning.
We will.
Roger Stone, the political consultant, writes this review of black socks and why you shouldn't wear them, and how Elliot Spitzer, the former governor of New York, wore them with the hookers.
While he was having sex with them.
Yeah, okay. I just got to read this one sentence. Spitzer denied he cavorted with prostitutes clad in mid-calf length black hose in a weird interview last week. In the interview, he dissed his wife, Dash, whom frankly I'd like to bang big time. In essence, saying he went looking for strange because after 25 years with the wife, the thrill is gone. Oh,
that's so in is it Daily Caller or The Daily Caller?
Either one.
Oh, The Daily Caller or DailyCaller.com.
DailyCaller.com, baby.
It's Tucker's new site. It's doing quite well, and Brent Hatley contributes on that as well. Tucker panders, of course, to anybody that'll give him the most money, and, you know.
Oh, 100%.
But,
are you kidding? And I'm pandering now to the BA on the Twitter machine.
The Bubba Army on the Twitter machine. Now, let me ask you a question. When's the last time you were on Fox?
I was on Fox yesterday.
Talking about what? Kissing whose ass?
Talking about, I think, Obama's budget.
Oh, the over $3 trillion budget?
It's insane. It's completely deranged with the largest deficit in the history of the country.
I want $3 trillion.
He has no idea, literally no idea what he's doing.
If you're going to be a bear.
Be a grizzly.
Yeah, why not?
I mean, if the bank's going to lend you the money, hey, I'd go in there and ask for the money.
Our country is a bunch of, we're white trash with a brand new credit card in the mail.
Completely. Getting up there and whining and blaming everyone else. I inherited this. No, you didn't. You just submitted a budget that we can't afford because things are out of control and you're doing nothing.
We haven't been able to afford our budget since 72.
You're right. No, that's absolutely right. Yeah. This was a guy who was going to, you know, make the hard choices and do things that were politically unpopular. He's been a coward.
He's done none of it.
Yeah.
Anyway, thedailycaller.com, Tucker's our boy. Follow him on Twitter. It's twitter.com/, what is it, Tucker Carlson?
Tucker Carlson.
Tucker Carlson. You watch. I'm going to do a call to action of being the sixth star of the Bubba Army, and you watch, and I'm going to knock your socks off, and that will weigh heavily into your consideration.
Yes, it totally will. That will affect how I feel about the Senate race.
Fantastic. Again, back to the lobbying tip.
I'm for sale, man. Come on, I'll admit it.
next Wednesday, I will be patiently waiting your reply next Wednesday on the air.
I'm dispatching a reporter right now.
Thank you, Tucker.
Thanks, guys.
Bye now.
He really cut to the chase.
Ow! Damn it!